Audio Jungle.
Alright, so this is the thrust equation for a turbojet engine. Thrust equation. For turbojet engine. Okay. So thrust, basically we have a two types of thrust. Okay. One is called momentum thrust, another is called pressure thrust. Two types of thrust we have, momentum thrust and pressure thrust. All right. So two types thrust we have. First one is called momentum thrust. Second comes from pressure thrust. All right. Now momentum thrust, in my previous lecture I had explained that momentum thrust because of the change in velocity, okay, change in velocity at the inlet and exit, and pressure thrust because of the pressure variation in the exit of the nozzle, and then whatever the surrounding pressure, because of that pressure difference we'll get the pressure thrust. Simply only, okay, that will give the pressure thrust. Okay, so now here this is the pressure thrust. So as we know, in general what is the pressure thrust, or pressure thrust, or basically it is pressure force, you can say. So what it is, we know pressure is equal to what? Force per unit area. So what is the force in general? What is the force? Force is the pressure force, and this is also called pressure thrust. So pressure thrust in the sense TP, pressure thrust, and it is nothing but pressure into area. Okay, so this is nothing but pressure area. And momentum thrust, it is coming from the Newton. Second law. What is this? Force is nothing but mass into acceleration. Mass into acceleration is nothing but dv by dt, or you can write mass. Why I am writing dot? I don't know. It's a chemical problem, no? In mind. Most of time it happens. I don't know why. So then we can write, because dt we can write t minus 0. dt is what? For short time of period. So starting you can say 0 and final is t. So dt is nothing but t minus 0, or t. M by t into change in velocity dv. M by t is nothing but m dot. Okay. What is m by t? It is nothing but m dot. Now it is mass flow rate. And dv is nothing but final minus initial, I can say vf minus vi. So this is nothing but momentum thrust. Okay, so this will be the thrust, and this thrust is nothing but momentum thrust. So what is the total thrust? What is the total thrust? Total thrust is nothing but T, and this is equal to momentum thrust plus pressure thrust. So this is the overall. As I told you, inlet you cannot show the atmospheric condition because nozzle is connected after turbine. Yes or no? So better I will show this diagram. So from this diagram, it will be more clear to you. See. All right. Now this is fine. Check here. So this is nothing but see. Okay. So here, this is nothing but inlet condition. You understood why I am taking the condition for you know full aircraft. Why I am taking? Because I want to show the inlet condition. And if you draw only nozzle, so that time you will not able to get the inlet as a atmospheric. Value, what pressure and you know velocity and all. So that's the reason I am just drawing the complete engine here, and I am considering this is the inlet of the engine. This is the inlet of engine. Okay, inlet, and this is the exit of engine. This is the exit of engine, and this is the inlet of engine. So at the inlet of engine, now that atmospheric pressure will be P infinity, and velocity will be free stream velocity. Okay. And the inlet area, I can say this inlet area is nothing but a I. Okay. Now this is the exit. So obviously here the pressure will be P E, and the most important velocity. Velocity will be V E. Okay. Velocity will be E V E, and pressure will be here P E, and the area will be a E. Okay. Exit area. Fine. In between. Obviously the here mass flow rate will be whatever the mass flow rate here you will have, that is the air. This is the air. Okay, but it is very clear now, you already have seen that previous lecture. So there is the one reason, and in that reason this was the combustion chamber. Okay, in the combustion chamber you have to add the mass of the fuel. Okay, so now what is the mass flow rate here? It is coming. I must say this. Sorry. So here, this will be the mass flow rate of exit, and this exit is nothing but mass flow rate of gas. I must say, and what is the gas? It is m dot a, which is air, plus m dot f, which is fuel. All right. Now I'm just going to write the momentum thrust first. So momentum thrust here you can write, check momentum thrust. Momentum thrust is nothing but TM, momentum thrust. How to write this? As I told you, by Newton's second law. What is the Newton's second law? The force is always mass into acceleration. It is proved already in previous lecture. So m into area, acceleration is nothing but rate of change of velocity dv by dt. This one I can write m divided by t into dv. I can write here. Okay, and this is nothing but m by t is nothing but m dot into dv. So what is the force? That force will be what? Thrust, or momentum thrust you can say, and it is nothing but mass flow rate into change in velocity. Yes or no? So it is the momentum thrust, and you can write m dot into change in velocity will be final velocity minus initial velocity. M dot into what is the final velocity? You can say it is exit. Okay, minus what is the initial velocity? It is inlet. Now if you open this, so how to connect this? So if you write this m dot vf minus m dot vi, I am just writing only mass flow rate. What will be the mass flow rate? That is another thing. So mass flow rate final you can write here, mass flow rate at inlet you can write. Now it will be better. So this will be mass flow rate of final velocity. So final velocity is nothing but exit. Okay, or fine. And don't consider this is m dot m, which is fuel. I'm writing final. Okay, this is the final. And now we are writing exit, so this mass flow rate will be exit, because m dot f meaning is mass flow rate of fuel also here, no? So don't get confused. So m dot e I will write now, which is the exit minus mass flow rate at the inlet into vi. This is the momentum thrust. So here it is nothing but momentum thrust. This is nothing but mass flow rate at exit into v exit minus mass flow rate at inlet into v inlet. What is the mass flow rate at the exit? Check the diagram here. Mass flow rate at the exit is nothing but m dot a plus m dot f. It is nothing but m dot a, which is the air, m dot f, which is the fuel, into v exit minus mi. Inlet mass flow rate was only air, m dot a into vi, and this vi I am writing here v infinity, right? In diagram only you can check. What is the inlet velocity? It is the v infinity, and inlet mass flow rate is m dot a, which is the air. Okay, so here the momentum thrust you got, you can write m dot a plus m dot f, exit velocity minus m dot a, and inlet velocity. So this is the momentum thrust. Okay, always remember, this is called momentum thrust. Okay, now in the momentum thrust also, again there is the manipulation, so all format I will write so that there should not be any problem. Okay, later on there should not be any problem. So now if you check this a formula what I have written here, next again I will write here Tm is equal to, what is that, m dot a plus m dot f into v exit minus m dot a into v infinity. Okay, so here in this formulation if you check what we have, two type of the products you have here, m dot a into v infinity and m dot a plus m dot f into ve. Okay, so here also this m dot a into v infinity, it is called intake drag. What it is called? Intake drag. And you know very well performance of the aircraft, it is finished. So in performance I had explained why thrust required, why thrust required in the aircraft to propel the aircraft. That is one thing, correct. But the second thing, because of the drag, if we do not have drag, then why thrust required? Once energy if you give, then it will go up to infinite, because we don't have any resistance force. But drag is the resistance force for the aircraft, just like for the current. If there is no resistance in the current, okay, so once the current will flow, then continuous energy supply not required. Yes or no? Because that current will be continuously flowing because there is no resistance, it will continuous. Why there is the electricity consumed? Because of the resistance. Yes or no? Because of the resistance only. That's then only you will pay the money in your meter and all, because energy will be consumed, and that energy will be consumed because of the resistance. That formula, if you remember, I square RT, I is the current, R is resistance, T is for how much time you have used. I square RT, that is the energy consumed by the appliances in your home. Yes or no? If there is no resistance, then energy consumed will be zero. You will not pay any single penny of money. Yes or no? So same thing for the aircraft, why the thrust is required? It is already explained in aircraft performance, because of the drag. Yes or no? Drag is there, hence you need thrust. So that time we said thrust required. Okay, so m dot a v infinity also called intake drag. Always remember, it is called intake drag. Okay. Then in the same way, we have the gross momentum thrust. What is the gross momentum thrust? M dot VE. Okay, M dot, because M dot F, which is the mass of the fuel fluid, which is very small, so many times we neglect also. So this M dot into VE, this will be called as gross momentum thrust. Okay, it is called gross momentum thrust. Okay, that you need to remember. What is the both component, what is the mean of it? Number one. Number two, this is what momentum thrust. One more point I need to discuss here. As you know, the component here, what we have, it is the M dot A. So it is the mass flow rate of air. M dot F, it is the mass flow rate of air. Okay, so one ratio will come, M dot F by M dot A, which is also called fuel by area, fuel by air. F by A, it is also denoted by small f. What is a small f? Small f called as fuel air ratio. What it is called? This is very important parameter they are asking in examination. Okay, fuel air ratio. Check here, M dot F is the fuel flow rate and M dot A is the air flow rate. So this ratio called as fuel air ratio. What it is called? Fuel air ratio. Okay, this value most of time it will be neglected, because whatever the amount of the fuel, okay, it is very very less than air. Okay, it is very very less than air. So many times it is neglected, but full once value they have given, or sometimes they will ask the value also. So in momentum thrust, we should know what is the actual mean of the fuel air ratio. Then fuel air ratio they have given, then how to calculate it. So that formula you have, second number, no? This is second, M dot A plus M dot F into exit velocity minus M dot A into V infinity. So here you can take the common, and what will be the common? A common you can take here, M dot A. So what you will get? 1 plus M dot F divided by M dot A into V E minus M dot A into V infinity. Check, this is what TM. Now what will be TM now? See, TM means momentum thrust, I am saying. So M dot A will be common for both. See, here also we have M dot A and here also we have. Now we can take common. So it will be M dot A for air, okay, and in bracket you can write 1 plus F into V exit. Check here, na? V exit, M dot F by M dot A is what? Fuel air ratio, small f, minus V infinity. Okay, this is very very important to know. If fuel air ratio, suppose they have given, then where and how to use that? Yes or no? So this should be very clear. V infinity. Now we'll keep this in a box. So this is the momentum thrust. This momentum thrust is what, in terms of fuel air ratio. If fuel air ratio, this is called F by A. Or if fuel air ratio, they said in problem, they said if fuel air ratio is neglected, so if they said it is neglected, then a small f you can take approximate to zero. Then what will be the momentum thrust. This momentum thrust will be m dot of air in bracket ve minus v infinity. This is the momentum thrust. So all are correct. Okay, the thing is, now you are the captain of your ship. Whatever the question will be there, accordingly you have to use the formula. Okay, this is C. Two, three types of the formulation I have given. This is number one. Number one formula. If m dot a, m dot f mass flow rate, they have given, use this. Okay. If they have given fuel air ratio, then use this. If they have said fuel air ratio is what neglected, only inlet and exit velocity they have given to us. So you take for the formula number 3 here. Okay, this is all about momentum thrust. Guys, remember this v infinity is the inlet velocity. Okay, there should not be any confusion, or I should write, then I will write here. Okay, v is the exit velocity and v infinity is the inlet, or I can say free stream velocity. Or it is the aircraft speed also. V infinity is the inlet velocity. This is inlet, okay. Inlet velocity. In the diagram, I will show you again so it will be more clear. See, this V infinity is the inlet velocity, or it is free stream velocity, or you consider atmosphere is what is static, there is no flow of air, then aircraft is what moving, then the same speed of the aircraft will be there, whatever the speed of the air, the same speed will be the aircraft. So free stream velocity, or in other reference you can say it is the aircraft speed, aircraft velocity better. So there should not be any confusion. Okay, and what is the VE? VE I told you, exit, or what it is called, exhaust. Exhaust velocity. Okay, so there should not be any kind of the confusion. I hope this one is clear to you. All right. So this is what the momentum thrust. AI minus AE. Infinity is nothing but AI minus AE. All right, we are talking about the pressure thrust. We are not talking about the momentum thrust. So velocity component we are not introducing here. Momentum thrust separately we have written. Okay, separately we have written. Now, so this pressure thrust, P infinity AI minus A exit. Now here if you check the frontal area of the control volume duct is AI, on which P infinity is exerted. Check in this diagram, P infinity is exerted. The side of control volume is the same as the internal area of the engine duct. Since the gas is exerting a pressure PS, okay, and in the duct as shown in figure here, okay, PS you have seen, this pressure is what exerted by the gas, okay. So if you check Newton's third law, the duct exert an equal and opposite pressure PS on the gas in the control volume, okay, yes or no? Because this pressure PS will be exerted by the gas, because inside that, you know, compressor is there, combustion chamber is there, turbine is there, so which is always higher than atmospheric pressure. So that gas will exert pressure PS, and as per Newton's third law, the duct, this duct will exert the same pressure PS, okay. So now the equation, if you check here, what we have Ps dS infinity AI minus AE, so we can write Ps into dS, which is nothing but P infinity AI minus P infinity AE. Okay, this one we can open. Now this is nothing but the pressure thrust. Okay, now if you talk about the value, like how to write this equation, we just say this is the equation number 2, second equation. Okay, and first equation we can say this one, this is the, we can say first equation. Okay, so first and second equation, once you go through it, okay, so what you will get, check, because one is momentum thrust, one is pressure thrust. So if you equate this equation, because both are the, one is, both are coming from the thrust component only, the difference is pressure thrust and momentum thrust. Okay, but the formula will be, is nothing but both side, it is the force only. Okay, so now if you equate that two values, so what you will get, check, you will get Ps dS, okay, integration minus P infinity AI plus PE AE, that I have opened that bracket, plus that Ps dS I had taken one side only, and the momentum thrust, if you keep that, then momentum thrust will be m dot a plus m dot a minus m dot a into v infinity. Okay, this is the Ps dS value. Now if you check this in terms of thrust, if you write, then this is nothing but we will have m dot f plus m dot a, sorry, here we should have to write ve, ve minus m dot a into v infinity. Okay, minus P infinity AI plus PE AE, okay, plus P infinity AI minus AE. Now if you solve this, then what value of the total thrust you will get? You will get the m dot f plus m dot a ve minus m dot a into v infinity, that two component will be cancelled out if you open it. So what you will get? You will get here pe ae minus infinity AE. So what will be the thrust? Check, it will be m dot a plus m dot a into VE minus m dot a V infinity plus PE minus P infinity into AE. This is the final, okay, this is the final thrust. This is nothing but final thrust. Now if here you check, one assumption we have, what is the assumption? This equation is the general equation of thrust generated by the turbojet engine. Okay, now again we can have assumption for this, and that assumptions are very simple. that assumptions are if the nozzle is what optimal expanded. Okay, if the nozzle is optimum or fully expanded to atmosphere. If you remember over expansion, under expansion, I had explained in the same way. If the nozzle is optimum or fully expanded, then what is the condition? It is PE is equal to atmospheric. So atmospheric pressure in the sense P infinity. That is the condition of fully expanded. I explained when I explained the CD nozzle over expanded under expanded condition. So if exit pressure is what expanded to the atmospheric condition, it is called fully expanded condition or optimum expanded condition. Then what will be the total thrust? The total thrust will be m dot a plus m dot f into ve minus m dot a into m dot a into v infinity plus pe minus p infinity into a. So check, if it is fully expanded, then this part will be zero. So for the expanded condition, pressure thrust will be zero. Fully expanded condition, pressure thrust will be zero. Okay, for optimum expansion. For optimum expansion, pressure thrust will be zero. Okay, that you need to remember. So here T is equal to, this is total thrust, m dot a plus m dot f ve minus m dot a into v infinity. This is the thrust equation of turbojet engine. Okay, this is the thrust equation of turbojet engine. Always remember. All right. So this is the equation I have derived for the turbojet. Similarly, you can write for the turbofan also. So if you go for the turbofan, then how to write? So we can write here. We are going to write the thrust equation for turbofan engine. Okay, thrust equation for a turbofan engine. So we have seen the thrust equation for the turbojet engine. So in the same way we can write. So but for that you need to see the diagram once. Already we had seen that turbofan diagram, so one more time I will draw so that I can write the thrust equation, because without diagram it is not possible, right? Because we should know the all velocity component, cold and hot velocity component, and area, cold nozzle area, hot nozzle area, that we should know. Then we can write the equation of thrust for the turbofan engine. Yes or no? So this is the equation, this is the diagram of the turbofan engine. This is the, I'm trying to draw turbo fan. My sketch is not so good, but try to understand this. Okay, this is the basically cowling. It is called cowling. Neat and clean diagram, so the things will be clear. Okay, to draw neat and clean, then things will be clear, otherwise there will be confusion. Okay, similarly, all right. So check this. The station number I will give to you. This is the air. Ambient air. Ambient air. So this station will be called zero or A, no? Then we have to give the name. This is what fan. This is the one compressor. LPC. Okay, this part is HPC. This is the burner. This is the HPT. This is the LPT. This is what fan. This is what fan. Okay, this is the called low pressure compressor. This fan is connected with this, no? So this is the low pressure compressor. Okay, this fan and this assembly itself low PC. Then this is called red one is called H high pressure compressor. High pressure compressor is what connected with the high pressure turbine. And see blue one, this one and this one is connected. This is LPC low pressure compressor. So this is the high pressure low pressure turbine. Okay, this is called burner, or you can say combustion chamber or combustor. This is the combustor. Okay, here fuel will be injected and dot up. Now check, this is called, because air, now just you have to focus. See, this is called hot nozzle. This is here what we are getting, hot air. So M dot A plus M dot F. Okay, and this is what hot nozzle. Okay, so whatever the velocity will have to say, it is hot velocity. This M dot A plus M dot F, we can write M dot A. What is this M dot A? M dot A, whatever the air passed through this generator, it will be the hot air. M dot hot plus M dot fuel. Okay, now focus here. This portion, this is the, I must say, whatever the air it is coming here, I will show the diagram. So see, the air will go like this. Air will go like this. Okay, so this is called cool nozzle. Okay, so what is the velocity here? Flow velocity coming outside, what it is called? This flow velocity outside, it is called M dot cold. Listen carefully, okay. And whatever the air entering here, because we have a burner here, so whatever the air entering here, this air now will be called M dot H, hot air. M dot hot. This is called M dot H. Let me write something. So this should be proper only, otherwise you may have a confusion. Okay, this is called bypass duct, that is true. And whatever the air here, this air is nothing but, I must say, whatever the air entering here, this air will be m dot HVAC, hot air. Okay, whatever the air entering going here, this is the m dot cold, because we don't have to burn fuel here. Okay, so the velocity will be, whatever the velocity here, this velocity will be v cold velocity. What is the velocity here? V hot velocity. What is the m dot air plus m dot fuel? So instead of m dot air, we have to write m dot h. Automatically it is understood, it is m dot h or m dot a, meaning will be same. Okay, m dot f, both velocity component. And obviously for the cool nozzle, because this is the bypass duct, this is what bypass duct. So what is the pressure here we get? There will be p cooled. What is the pressure here? It will be p hot. Okay, exit pressure, I'm talking about exit pressure. And inlet pressure will be same for all, but in the inlet pressure it is p infinity. Okay, so this is the now complete, you can say, turbofan. Okay, this is what fan, and this is the intake. This is what intake here. All right, so now the intake. So now we need to write the thrust equation, just like a turbojet we have written. Okay, so there should not be any confusion. Just like a turbojet we have written, the same way we have to follow for the turbofan. Only the difference here is the nozzle. How many nozzles we have? Two nozzles. One is cool nozzle, one is hot nozzle. So definitely we'll get even momentum thrust as well as pressure thrust from both nozzle. Okay, from both nozzle. So direct equation I will write. Again, I will not derive, because for turbojet we have seen the derivation. So similar way we can say equation of turbofan. Here we can write this is nothing but thrust total. Okay, in turbofan it is thrust due to hot nozzle plus thrust due to cold nozzle. Okay, area for both need to write, that area of the hot nozzle as well as area of the cool nozzle. So now see the equation. Okay, just try to connect it. I must say exit area I have given or not. Okay, so exit area, this is the exit area of hot nozzle, and here we can say somewhere here this is the exit area of cold nozzle. Okay, now fine. So check this equation. So first I will write for the hot nozzle, so I will use red. Okay, so in hot nozzle, what we will have, we'll have the m dot. Okay, what m dot air will write, or we can write that m dot hot air, or simply if I will write m dot h, it means you need to understand this is the hot air. Okay, this is the air only. M dot h or m dot hot means it is the air, but hot air, simple. M dot hot plus m dot fuel. Okay, I'm writing momentum thrust plus into v exit. V exit of what? Hot minus inlet. What is the inlet? M dot air, but this air is what? Hot air, into velocity. And what is the velocity? It is the inlet velocity and it is the v infinity. Okay, so this is the momentum thrust for hot nozzle. What is the pressure thrust? Pressure thrust will be exit pressure minus inlet pressure. So exit pressure what? For what? Exit pressure for hot nozzle minus inlet pressure. So that will be common P infinity, but what will be the area? Area will be A exit, but it is for hot. Yes or no? Plus, now we'll write for the cold. So I will write this color. So thrust due to cold. So again, what is the in cold nozzle, what is the hot air? We do not have any fuel, right? Only air will be there. But what is the air? It is cold air. So I can write m dot cold air in, but m dot will not be there, m dot f will not be there, because we are not burning any fuel. Okay, so it will be only m dot cold. In bracket we will write exit velocity of the cold nozzle minus inlet velocity of the cold nozzle. So that will be common V infinity. V infinity for hot nozzle and cold nozzle both, no? Inlet will be same for all, and pressure thrust will be P exit of the cold nozzle minus P infinity, which is inlet pressure, and this is the A exit of cold nozzle. Yes or no? So the final formula I will write here, so please connect it. And this is nothing but I will write T, total thrust of the turbofan. We can take m dot h, that is the air will take common. So m dot f by m dot h will be the fuel air. Okay, so from here we'll start. So this is m dot, instead of hot complete I will write h. So you need to understand m dot h. Okay, if you take 1 plus mf by m dot h, then it will be 1 plus f. Okay, try to connect it, it's simple only. 1 plus f, exit velocity of hot, v exit. So I will write capital H only, hot, minus, you have taken common, so it will be only v infinity. So this is the momentum thrust, plus coming to the pressure thrust. So I will write p exit h only, hot, minus v infinity. So this is nothing but a exit hot only plus m dot c, cold in the sense m dot c in bracket v e cold minus v infinity plus p e cold means c minus p infinity into a e cold c. This is the final formula of the turbofan, and for this reason only they are not asking turbofan in your exam. Okay, if they will ask, they will ask very simple question. I will solve previous year gate questions, it will be not clear, but the big question they will not ask, because the formula itself very lengthy. So this is the thrust equation of fan engine, turbofan engine. So how we can write? Simply, we had seen the in previous year, we had see this is the turbojet, so the full derivation you have seen. Okay, so in the same way, like for turbojet you have written, you have derived, same thing you can do for the turbofan. So I have not derived from the starting, I just draw the diagram, I have shown you the all component, then I have shown you the different station, and now you are like aware with the momentum thrust and pressure thrust. So you should concentrate only exit velocity, inlet velocity, exit pressure and inlet pressure, that's all. That is the only value will be used for the calculation of thrust. Yes or no? Rest you forget everything, because once we solve the problem, then we will see the internal part, like where is compressor, and for the compressor what is the pressure and what is the temperature. That is secondary part, we don't have to go in that. We have to write only the equation based on turbojet, what we have derived, what we have seen. The same way we can write for this turbofan also. So all the components now in front of you.